Let's go ahead and start with the endpoint. It's simply a Wikipedia URL with a search string put inside. So far, so good. Then we come to the AJAX request object. We start off by creating a URL parameter and setting it equal to the wiki URL that we just created. If we didn't want to pass the URL in as a parameter of this object, it could actually just be a string by itself that comes before this settings object inside this method call. In other words, we could have passed the URL in here as a string before the settings object instead of making it a parameter of the settings object, but either way works. Then we set the data type to JSONP, indicating that this is a JSONP request, and then we have a success function. I've got a line commented out here for JSONP as a parameter, setting JSONP to callback. Some APIs want to use a different name for the callback function. By default, using JSONP as a data type will set the callback function name to callback, so this line here is actually redundant. But if we needed to change it, in other words, if we needed to change this callback right here, in that case, we would use a different string here on the JSONP property. Check the instructor notes for more on JSONP. Inside the success parameter, we've got this anonymous function, which is run when we get the response. Let's take a look at this response in the browser. Inside the network tab, we can see this request for Wikipedia. Let's click on it, and it looks like we've got a JavaScript object. Like we said before, this JavaScript object is going to be wrapped within a function, so we can see this long string here as the function. It looks like we've got a few sections, including main, which has some information. Inside, we finally come to this parameter 1, which has an array of different articles about San Francisco. Now, you'll notice here how there are spaces between the words in the response, but that's okay. We can actually just use this inside our URLs. You'll notice that if I right-click on one of these and click Copy Link Address, and then paste it into my browser, we see that those spaces are replaced with %20. When we press Enter, we see that Wikipedia is smart enough to redirect us to San Francisco's URL. So we create this article list variable that we set equal to the array of articles, remember that parameter 1, from the object that got returned from Wikipedia, which is the response, and then we simply iterate through it. Each article gets appended to the page inside a list element using an A tag, and we simply set the URL to the URL that we create here, and its article string, which is the name of the article, which we saw in the response. And with that, we've got a pretty awesome page.